Good morning. My name is Pastor Elmo Herman from sunny Jamestown, North Dakota. I am outdoors today to bring to you this short message. I am near the marina on the reservoir in on the north side of Jamestown, North Dakota. I don't have a lot of time to share this message, but I thought a good theme for today, in light of all the things that are happening in our lives, has to do with the importance of living by faith. Abraham is one of my favorite characters in all the Bible except for Christ and maybe the Apostle Paul. But living by faith is something we all have the opportunity of doing these days. And what a joy it is to have all the resources that we have. And yet with all the technology and all the resources, God still provides for us the opportunity to live by faith. Let's pray together before we get started. Gracious God, I thank you for this beautiful outdoor location. I thank you for the world in which we live. I thank you for all the resources that you place into our care and into our lives. And I thank you for a beautiful time that we can share together. Thank you for your presence wherever we go. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Well, in Genesis chapter 12, God calls Abraham to leave his home country and his hometown. He was a wealthy person. He had lots of resources. So he took his entire family, his extended family, and he leaves. One of the challenging things is the fact that God is testing his faith in the area of personal security. We all have personal securities. I remember hearing a story one time visiting a family that they had a child that was struggling with personal security, so they brought out a great big blanket. It's all they had at the time. They lived too far from town to have a nice little one designed for children. And then the child, as it got bigger, as weeks went by and months went by, it was carrying this great big long blanket wherever they went around the house. If it went in the living room or kitchen or bedroom or wherever, it even tried going outside a few times carrying this great big long blanket. So they had the great idea of cutting the blanket in half. And they just kind of kept cutting it in half until they had like a 1 square foot piece this child could carry along. And then it finally got old enough, it realized it didn't need the comfort of a blanket anymore. Well, we all have things that give us personal security. Maybe we've lived in a house for a long time. Maybe we've driven the same vehicle for a long time. Maybe we've gone somewhere for breakfast for a long time, or a favorite place to camp or fish or play golf. And all those things are things of personal security. Even these days, a lot of people have their own place they like to sit in church when they worship. And now we're having to worship online because of a pandemic. But you know, we all have choices to make, and God, in light of all circumstances, invites us to be flexible in the area of personal security. In fact, he goes one step further than that. He talks about faith being a wonderful sense of personal security for us. There are things that come and go in our lives. Our health. Oftentimes our health is pretty good, and then other times overnight it can change without warning. Maybe it's the balance in our checking account or in our savings account. And by the way, if you're looking for a way to free yourself up, we'd be happy to help you with that. So we thank you for supporting so many wonderful organizations, and churches especially are struggling to stay afloat these days. As we think of personal security, we want to remember that Abraham was leaving his home country, that area that he knew for his whole life. And he was 75 years old. He was not a young person. And he was heading out, and I don't know if his joints felt like our joints when people these days hit 75 years old, but he was not a young person. And to go out on this adventure and to have his faith tested by God was not an easy thing. The very same thing, the very same time, we want to be mindful of how important it is to surrender those things in our life that we hang on to that could be places of personal security for us instead of our faith in God. And there are many adjustments and many times of transition that people make in their lives. And we want to make sure that we hang on to things loosely, because things in our life are always subject to change. It is only our faith in the living Lord Jesus Christ that lasts forever, and our faith in God that lasts forever. The Apostle Paul talks about personal securities in Philippians chapter 4. I talked about that last week. And the Apostle Paul says, you know, I've had times in my life when I've had plenty to eat. I have been well fed. I've had times in my life that I have been hungry. I simply didn't have enough food to eat, and I didn't have a decent place to stay. In fact, the Apostle Paul spent plenty of time in prison because of his faith. Yet at the same time, he discovered that it was possible for him, because of his faith, to find peace and find contentment. Well, hanging on to personal securities loosely is really important. And sometimes we're tempted to hang on to our confidence in the government, which is important. And we're tempted to look at science or medicine. And then God gives Abraham a sign, gives him a word picture, and gives him a promise. He says, Abraham, if you are willing to trust me in the area of personal security, I will make you the father of a great nation. And so he says, Abraham, look to the stars. And he started looking to the stars, and he started counting them, and he discovered that there were a lot of stars in the sky, the same way that there's still a lot of stars today. And he says, as many stars as there are in the heavens, you're going to be the father of all these wonderful people. And today, as we read the New Testament, especially in the book of Hebrews, it tells us that Abraham is the father of a great nation, but it's going to take some time. And our faith is tested not only in the area of personal security, but our faith is tested in the area of patience. Now, it's great that we have some people that are simply very, very patient people. It's great to live in a family where perhaps mom and dad or both people are very patient, or maybe it's grandparents are very patient. I loved to watch the program The Waltons from time to time, or Little House on the Prairie, and there's characters on there that are folks that are just very, very patient people. They hardly never lose their cool. They always kind of know what to say, and they're always very gracious and loving people. Patience is a very important quality in the Bible. I'm going to move a little closer to my Bible here. I'm actually taping this outside my vehicle, so I have a little wind protection. And it is 42 degrees and slightly windy here today. But the Apostle Paul says this about patience in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4, that love, God's love, agape love, is always patient. And God's love is always kind. And when we communicate and we live out God's agape love, and we live out God's grace and kindness, it means that one of the high values in our life is to be loving and is to be patient. And that this kind of love never boasts, it's never proud, it's never dishonoring. It means it's always showing honor. And how important it is. I was going through some Facebook pictures the other day, and somebody was taking a picture of their family, and the guy had a t-shirt on with the word honor. And I noticed that honor is a very important value in the Bible. It means that we are placing high value on everyone. And when we honor someone and we place high value in someone's life, it doesn't matter if they have similar qualities as we do, or if they have qualities that are slightly different. When we honor someone, we want to be mindful of how important it is to see the good and healthy and positive qualities in their life. And so it is wonderful to be able to honor everyone. When we say yes to Jesus Christ, it means that we are inviting Christ and God the Holy Spirit and God's love and grace into our life, and we become a member of God's family. It gives us the opportunity to be patient with everyone. And the key to being patient is being able to use God's grace and God's love and God's strength to be very, very patient. Because when we try to be patient in our own strength, it doesn't always work so well because we simply get exhausted or we get tired. And if we think back to times when we perhaps have lost our patience in a circumstance, many times it's because we have been tired or it's been a long day. And we want to be mindful of how important it is to live a balanced life, how important it is to eat balanced meals, and especially get plenty of sleep. And Americans today are struggling getting sleep because they are concerned about what's happening the next day. Well, we want to be mindful of how important it is to trust the Lord and to allow His Spirit to fill us. The important thing to remember is that the energy that we had yesterday may not be the same level of energy that we have today. And so it's important to start our day with prayer, and it's important to start our day thinking about the promises of Holy Scripture. It's important to continue to reach out and develop strong musical influences in our life. It's important to stay connected using whatever means it is, whether it's texting someone back and forth, whether it's using Facebook or Instagram or whatever source that is out there, even phone calls. There's nothing more important sometimes than hearing the actual voice of someone rather than just reading a message on a smartphone or on a computer screen. Well, patience goes a long way. I want to thank you in advance for being patient and be patient. And even if we have sometimes lost our patience, it's important to go back and to restore those relationships. And maybe an apology is needed. Maybe we've been uptight. Maybe we have said something that could have been said in a gracious way or a more kinder way. And so sometimes it goes a long way just to say, I'm sorry, I said it that way. And next time I promise to do better. Well, our faith is tested in many areas in life. And Abraham had to wait a very, very long time for his son to be born, Isaac. He was about almost 100 years old before Isaac was born, and Sarah was in her 90s. In fact, when God was coming to Abraham and said, Abraham, now is the time. I'm going to give you that son that you have been waiting for such a long time. He went to tell Sarah, and Sarah laughed. And of course, in Hebrew, the word Isaac means to laugh. It's laughter. So Abraham believed God. Sarah really didn't, but Isaac was born anyhow. I'm hoping that in time, Sarah, as she was developing Isaac in her womb, started believing. I'm confident that's probably what happened. But initially, she was in her 90s, and who these days wants to have a baby when they're 90 years old? Well, probably not too many people. Well, Abraham passed the test of personal security, where he leaves his home territory, and he starts looking for that area that God was going to show him. He also passed the test when Isaac was born, and believing that even if he was well advanced and Sarah was in her 90s, that they would have a promised child and he would be the father of a great nation. And Isaac was growing up. He was a teenager. And then the third important test came to Abraham's life, and it had to do with an impossible circumstance. Abraham comes to God one day and he says, Abraham, I want to know if you really love me. I want to know if you really believe in me. I want to know if you're going to put me first in your life. I want you to take your one and only son, that son that you have waited so long for. I want you to take him up to Mount Moriah and offer him as a sacrifice for me. And so Abraham goes and he takes some servants and they collect some woods and they make the trip from wherever they were at to to the base of Mount Moriah, and the servants are there, and they grab some wood, and they head up, and they make an altar on the top of Mount Moriah. And Isaac says to his dad, "Dad, where is the lamb for the sacrifice?" And he takes Isaac, and he lays him on the altar, and he ties him up, and he pulls out his knife, and he's prepared to offer his son as a sacrifice to God. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 22 that God stopped his arm and God stopped his sword and provided a sacrifice for Abraham. A lamb or a goat or a ram was found in the bushes. And as we read that story from Genesis chapter 18 to Genesis chapter 22 and all the way past Genesis chapter 22 into chapter 26, we're going to find some interesting details about Abraham's life. Please take time to read it. But oftentimes we are confronted without notice, without having time to prepare, with impossible situations. Farmers these days have impossible situations to deal with because the prices of the grains and the meats and the beef and the pork is going so low that it's almost impossible to make it work. We're going to find the oil industry. They're having to pay people to take the oil to other places. Who would have thought a number of years ago when gas prices were $3 and $4 that now in some places in the nation it's under $1, like 95 cents in some places in the South. We're going to find medical people are stretched beyond belief because of pandemic. We have doctors that are running out of energy and nurses that are running out of energy. We have people working in the grocery stores as frontline people. We have concerns about will our food last? And the list just goes on and on and on about some of the impossible situations that people are experiencing when their jobs have been furloughed or their jobs have come to an end and they're heading into unemployment. Some people have no unemployment and they have to scramble trying to figure out how am I going to pay my bills? Well, my friend, I want to encourage you with the thought and the hope and the promise that God is the same God who provided for Abraham is also going to provide for you and for me. And so today, I want to encourage you to make God your number one priority in your life. I want to encourage you to be patient in the faith journey, that it's important that we communicate in such a way that we are using God's energy and God's grace and God's love and God's kindness, and that we do all we can to support everybody we possibly can. And we also want to be mindful of how important it is to be faithful in the little things in life. Even when things are out of our control, even when things seem to be impossible. Well, Abraham passed the test in all these areas, and it's my hope and prayer that you and I will continue to pass the test in these areas as well. Let's pray together. Gracious God, I thank you for the living Christ. I thank you for the hope that we have. Not only in believing that he died for our sins on the cross, but that he rose again on the third day. And I thank you for the joy of enjoying all the wonderful things we're able to enjoy and experience in life. And I thank you for being there through the joyful times of life. And I thank you for being there through the challenging times of life. Help us, O God, to understand the wisdom of living with your Spirit, giving us insight and direction and power to move forward with a new hope and a new confidence. Grateful for this time we could share together. It's my hope and prayer that you would bless those people who have medical needs and bless those people who have financial needs and bless military people and bless people who are separated from their families during this time. Bless scientists who are looking for an answer to this pandemic. We pray for our military people who are oftentimes separated, and for doctors and nurses and ambulance and law enforcement people. We just lift them all up to you, and we thank you in advance for an answer. Thank you for the opportunity we have to share the good news during these trying times. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Well, I want to thank you for joining me. Once again, it's Pastor Elmo Herman from sunny Jamestown, North Dakota. You're going to see behind me again the reservoir. I'm going to step off to the side so you can see a little better picture of it. And that's the island. And the marina is kind of to that direction, to your left, my right. And in fact, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this, if I can